In the light of Calvary, God has high expectations of us. So let us continue the fight of God's Son against evil. In God's Spirit, we find peace passing all understanding. So let us remember to pass God's peace to future generations. Ancient of Days, our shield and defender, attend our prayers in the Spirit as we prayerfully remember those who have placed their lives in the service of their fellow citizens, so that we might have the freedom to worship you today in spirit and in truth. For we call upon you in the name of Christ Jesus, who taught his disciples to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. A reading of Psalm 29. Ascribe to the Lord, O heavenly beings, ascribe to the Lord glory and strength. Ascribe to the Lord the glory of his name. Worship the Lord in holy splendor. The voice of the Lord is over the waters. The God of glory thunders. The Lord over mighty waters. The voice of the Lord is powerful. The voice of the Lord is full of majesty. The voice of the Lord breaks the cedars. The Lord breaks the cedars of Lebanon. He makes Lebanon skip like a calf, and Sirion like a young wild ox. The voice of the Lord flashes forth flames of fire. The voice of the Lord shakes the wilderness. The Lord shakes the wilderness of Kadesh. The voice of the Lord causes the oaks to whirl and strips the forest bare. And in his temple all say, Glory. The Lord sits enthroned over the flood. The Lord sits enthroned as King forever. May the Lord give strength to his people. May the Lord bless his people with peace.
In preparation for silent prayer, we remember John Titherington, Reverend Roger Briggs, Jonathan Shea, Peggy Lynn, Carol Langlois, Sean Smith, Mia Falvey, Cody Pound, Perry Green, Finn Daly, Kayla Daly, Brooke Daly, Daniela and Matteo Ciriello, living with a rare blood disorder, and their parents and all medical staff devoting their lives to helping children, the people of the Middle East, all prisoners of war, all service women and servicemen, all innocents caught up in violence and unrest, all God's creatures, both great and small. Let us pray. Almighty God, Lord of the worlds and ruler over time, we come before you knowing that you hear our prayers, both spoken and unspoken. From everlasting to everlasting, your love and mercies are steadfast, and so we lift up our hearts to seek your favor, knowing that you will include you and inclining our ears to us. Grant us clarity of spiritual vision as we seek to build a more peaceful community and a more humane society. Abide with us always. Uphold us. Stand by us. For we need you this and every hour. O champion of the oppressed, we pray to you as the guardian of the orphan, the widow, the strangers among us, and the dispossessed. Your care and concern for us is unending, expressed through the salvation offered to the world in which we live. Our hope is in you. We would share word of your love, not just through our own speech, but through our deeds performed in accordance with the teachings of your Son, our example and our guide. Give us the courage to remain true to Christian ideals, that we might reflect your image in our lives and draw other lives to you. O God, in whom we place our trust, we rely on your goodwill and favor, and yet so often take them for granted. Remind us that we have a story to tell, a story of selfless love, of sacrifices cheerfully made, of generosity and liberality, all in the name of your Son. We stand in awe, O Heavenly Father, of your amazing grace and your unchanging faithfulness. We pray that the quality of our lives might mirror your boundless and infinite interest in our well-being, as we pray for our human family, as well as the entire creation. God of grace and God of glory, pour out your power upon your people. Reshape us, renew us, transform us in the likeness of your Son, that our lives might confess the beauty of holiness, the hope of eternity, and the joy of peace. May our hearts be guarded from despair as we pray for lives filled with praise and thanksgiving for the blessings that have been showered upon us, so that as we continue our pilgrimage of faith, we might share those blessings with others. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Our scripture lesson is from the Gospel according to Matthew, chapter 10, starting at verse 34. These are the words of Christ. Do not think that I have come to bring peace to earth. I have not come to bring peace, but a sword. For I have come to set a man against his father, and a daughter against her mother, and a daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law. And one's foes will be members of one's own household. Whoever loves father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. And whoever loves son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And whoever does not take up the cross and follow me is not worthy of me. Those who find their life will lose it. And those who lose their life for my sake will find it. Here end the morning scripture lessons. It's time to put on our thinking caps again, but let's at least start things off easy. Permit me to state from the outset an obvious truth. Jesus defies normal human categorization. He's a man who said, "If you're struck upon the right cheek, then turn the other cheek, that you might be struck there also. Do not answer evil with evil, but with good." But then Jesus also said, "I have come not to bring peace, but a sword." He was a man who would do nothing to oppose the hated Roman oppressor, deciding instead to render unto Caesar what was Caesar's. Yet he also braided a bullwhip and drove the money changers from the temple. Of course, it's not that Christ condoned violence, bullwhips notwithstanding. Far from it. Jesus sought harmony rather than conflict and discord. But for Jesus, there was something even more important than harmony itself. There was a greater ideal at stake. The 20th century Spanish philosopher Miguel Unamuno wrote, "May God deny you peace, but give you glory." In the previous century, the German philosopher Nietzsche said, "I like my truths bloody." In very different ways, I think they were pointing in the same direction, and in doing so reflected what Jesus was trying to point out to us. What all three tried to show is that while harmony is an important value, an important idea, truth stands above harmony. On this Memorial Day weekend, I'd like us to consider the relationship between those two great virtues of truth and harmony for a moment. For example, there is no way that a great cause can arise and not bring division, whether within families or among the populace of entire nations. The movements to abolish slavery, not just here in our country, but anywhere on the planet. The movement to establish an 8-hour workday. The push to grant the right to vote to more than landowners. To assure equal protection under the law, all demonstrate that fact. The struggle to assure workers meaningful labor rights saw blood in the streets of our cities. Universal suffrage battles were fought just as much in our living rooms as in the public arena. And we are still dealing today with questions of what equality actually means. So it is with the gospel. For there is no way that the good news of God with us can come into our lives without changing us. And others might not care for the resulting change they see in our lives as we attempt to make sense of what God requires of us in our relationships with one another. Truth can unbalance social realities, and conflict is often the result. Further problems arise when we confuse the charge to stand and fight for things spiritual, but confuse that fight with championing one secular cause over another. In Scripture, the Apostle Paul emphasizes that his conflict, ultimately, is not with this world. For the world is but a shadow of the true world, the world which is to come. Paul would suggest that if we're going to fight, let's be very clear as to what we're fighting for, why we are fighting, and what means we use in our strife. The Apostle Paul cautions us to realize that our conflict as the church is spiritual conflict. Or as the psalmist put it, we are not to place our trust in horses and chariots, but in the Lord himself. Put another way, we are to pick our enemies wisely. Even in spiritual battles, we sometimes shirk our duties. Some of us, like the Apostle Peter, like to play it safe, denying what it is we should be standing for. Even the very idea of engaging in spiritual battles makes a lot of people, even today, uncomfortable. Thing is, Christ does not call the church to a life of untroubled comfort. Jesus did not himself lead a life of ease. Rather, he spoke of human life as being like the grass of the fields, which flourishes but a day and then is used to make a fire. Jesus spoke of the crosses that each one of us is to bear. Crosses that are given not so much to please us as if we could pat ourselves on the back for bearing them, but the crosses are there to fulfill our own true destiny. For he who finds his life will lose it, and he who loses his life for Christ's sake will find it. Memorial Day, like the very history of our own country, reflects both life and death. It is a day about those who faced tough choices, which often called for ultimate sacrifices. It is a day about truth, and the notion that sometimes the truth brings conflict instead of peace. Truth can bring disorder instead of comfort. As we celebrate this Memorial Day, may we remember all those who died to end injustice, who died to fight oppression, who died to make us free. for in so doing they have individually done no less than pay the price once again that was paid at Calvary. Let us who have benefited from such sacrifices take them truly to heart, so that no others may be called upon to make those same sacrifices in the cause of truth ever again. Amen. May the love of God the Father, the grace of God the Son, and the fellowship of God the Holy Spirit be with us and in our homes and with our loved ones now and forevermore. Amen.